with the AP fever, the thing that I just see is people who are just like, you know, for 2 weeks straight working their, you know, tails off, you know, tired and stressed, and just kind of things are being a mess. It's not a required admissions criteria. You know, your grades are the admissions criteria. So taking the AP class, ensuring that rigor is what matters, but don't redirect energy to the AP prep away from classes. They get their grade in the class, and then in the middle of the summer, the AP score shows up. So I, as a teacher, cannot factor that you got a 2, you know, or a 1, and you dialed it in. I can't factor that into your grade. The AP score will be completely separate from the grade that you get in the class. That's the grade you get in class that matters most. I mean, and to be fair, if you are great at calculus, you're great at Spanish, and you can get a, you know, 4 or 5, I'd absolutely do that. But if you're currently at a 2 and you're gonna have to spend 100 hours in preparation, it's probably just not worth it, because it's 100 hours of your life you're not willing to spend. And I just worry that if you're spending so much energy on those APs, where they only matter a little bit because they're not required by universities, if you can shine with them, do that. But if you don't, well, okay. Remember, with AP exams, you can get your grade back, your score back. And if it's really strong, you send it off to the college or universities you're applying to. And if you're like, you just don't send it, right? The colleges can't afford you to take the exam. Maybe you're sick that day. And again, so much of this is really based on fear. There's a great study the University of North Carolina did looking at AP exams and how many exams different students took. And then they looked at the correlation between the number of APs that folks took and their performance as undergrad students at the University of North Carolina. So they found that from 0 to 5, the more AP classes, and I believe AP tests that the students took, the better they did. But once they got to 5, it was a plateau. From 5 to 11, it didn't make any difference. If you took 7 and I took 5, that didn't make you any better as a learner in college than I was. And once they got to 11, it actually went down. Academic performance in college went down. And part of that may be that it's fear, you know, that it's fear driven, right? Rather than driven by what I'm really into. Because I take every AP in the world, I can't decide, but I just have more must be better. If we think about high school as 4 years of developing yourself as a learner, with the idea that you're planning to go to college, right? And you want to do well in college, or maybe even after college, you're planning to go to graduate school. So if we think about high school as really foundational, we don't want to be just, you know, piling up credentials. When we choose these AP classes, pick things that are challenging to you, but in class that you like, because you're trying to develop yourself as a learner, not a 4-year arc of high school, but an 8-year arc of high school into college. And think about high school is really not an addition process for college, but also as a development process for how am I going to be successful as a learner in college.